there were a simple way to protect your kids from illness, both now and in the future? Dr. Joel Fuhrman says you can, and he tells you how and disease-proof your child. Welcome.
Thank you. Great to be here.
Thank you. Tell me about the link between what our kids are eating and childhood disease.
Well, it's a shame that our children in America today are eating 90% of calories from sugar, oil, dairy products, and white flour. That's 90% of their caloric intake. Only 4% of the calories that American children eat come from fresh fruit, fresh produce.
They're like eating fresh fruits and vegetables. This. We'll show you some of the things, and tell me what's bad about this, because there's sugar, there's fat, but this is what you see in most American homes nowadays.
You know, we've spent $400 billion on cancer research, and the death rate from cancer has been flat in the last 30 years. But we couldn't get the best nutritional scientists in the room together and design a diet from scratch to create a cancer epidemic. We couldn't do a better job than feeding the foods our kids eat today.
Tell us why.
The World Health Organization is predicting a doubling of the cancer rate worldwide in the next 20 years. But look, we know that vitamins and minerals are not enough. We need that third class of nutrients called phytochemicals or antioxidants. Those are only found in those classification of foods: fruits, vegetables, beans, nuts, and seeds. Foods that nature or God made for us to enjoy in the kingdom. In the kingdom of,
right. See what we prepared for you?
You know, it's that when you eat natural food, those phytonutrients don't just protect us against cancer, but they prevent viruses from taking a more virulent form, prevent that little infection, that cold, turning into attacking the heart or attacking the brain or infecting your nerves. In other words, we're learning with recent research that even a simple viral illness can be more dangerous without the phytochemicals in place.
Okay, I'm with you. I'm with you on the phytochemicals now. How do I get my 8 and my 10-year-old to eat this? How do I get them to eat this?
You know, and with these foods, you have the trans fats, the high sugar, the high, you know, it's where they're full of saturated fat. We're not only not eating the nutrients, but we're eating a rich level of those fats that create an imbalance in our tissues affecting brain function, leading to allergies, asthma, attention deficit disorder, and of course later life problems.
But Which allows me to ask, how do I get them to eat this?
There's three ways, simple ways. The most important way is the parents have to model the diet they want their child to eat.
Oh, that's so key. Isn't that the key? If we want our kids to eat healthier foods, we have to be doing the same
thing. You can't be a hypocrite. Yeah. You can't tell your kid, oh, that's not for you, while you're eating a different menu. You've got to show them the good menu. Then you've got to teach them the intellectual reasons, even as a child. Kids at 2 and 3 and 4 and 5, they're not stupid. They learn, and they learn why.
Although with a 2-year-old, how are you going to communicate that? It's more like this is
what. No, but a 2-year-old, you don't. When they're that age, between 1 and 2, you don't have to communicate it, because those are the foods you have in your home.
Right.
They're going to eat the foods they're presented with. A 2-year-old doesn't go to drive to McDonald's and put French fries and chips and donuts in their mouth unless the parents give it to them.
Tell me something.
As they get older, though, and they're exposed to the outside environment, and they're being, and they have these foods around them, they have choices to make. By that time, they've learned that they build their body as they get older. Like, I'll say to my son, who's now 4 years old, I'll say, Sean, you can't eat all that kale with the cashew butter cream sauce. I need it for my power, for work. He goes, no, I want it, Dad. I said, then you'll be too powerful. You're like, no. He says, power. And I go flying over the couch with a backflip, and I go, get that broccoli and garlic away from that kid. He's eating too much green vegetables. And his friends are jumping over, trying to shove the green vegetables in their mouth. You know,
I love that. Make it fun.
We make it fun in my house. We make it delicious. My kids are proud of the fact they make, like, ice cream out of strawberries, like frozen strawberries whipped with a little piece of dried pineapple and an orange in the blender.
I'm getting this. And I think a lot of people at home are getting this too. So so you're saying make it fun. Make it fun for the kids. Model it. And what else? What else can we do to get them to eat this over this?
You know, a child, like any other species of animals, is going to be driven to consume the most concentrated calories
we can find. Although we are more than animals because we have God in us. We are made in God's image, and I'll get off my soapbox now.
But you've got that intellectual choices you can make, and you use that intellect and your intelligence and what you've learned about God to know why you should eat in the nature's kingdom. But your child has to have that environment in his household. He can't have all this stuff around him and expect to eat this stuff. In other words, the fourth thing we didn't mention is if your child was shipwrecked on Gilligan's Island, he'd be eating food that God made. And he would do fine with it, and he'd love it, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. We put him back into the toxic food environment in America, he's not gonna choose broccoli over a cheese doodle over a pizza. He's gotta have, your household has to be the Gilligan's Island. Mm-hmm. You know, that's how you know. You can't be overweight on Gilligan's Island. You couldn't have these foods and be overweight. That's
Let's
how you know.
Let's just send them all to Gilligan's Island.
Right,
I say we just send them all for a 3-hour tour.
Well,
now, let me ask you something. In school,
instead.
Though, in school, and I have to say our kids go to a school that's really great. They have good, healthy choices. They have the salad bar. But in a lot of schools and in our culture, the bad choices are just right there. There's pizza day. There's chocolate chip cookies. There's all of this stuff. How do you get it in their heads to make really good choices? You have the foundation, you're starting.
Right.
Let's say you have teenagers and you're just hearing this for the first time, you're watching us from home. How do you begin now?
You know, I lecture to schools and to teenagers and they raise their hand and they say, how do I get my parents to eat this way? They, you know, when they're not stupid, when they can be taught that the bodies that their cells are growing and replicating, and when they mature, they're gonna get the body when they're an adult that they created as a child,
right,
and they're gonna pay a price with breast cancer or colon cancer or ovarian cancer or heart attacks or diabetes or dementia. They're gonna pay a price from the junk food they built, the body they made when they were young. And kids, you'd be amazed at how smart children are.
But we can turn this around, can't we?
I
mean, if we've grown up eating junk, we can turn it around.
That's right, it's education. Mm-hmm. We have to educate, and then the whole, there's not a diet just made for this teenager. The whole family sits down. And democratically, they make their own new rules up on their own decisions. They get the information, they study it together, they get excited about it, and they make it fun. And you don't, not a question of pleasure versus health.
Right.
Healthy foods can taste just as good as the unhealthy food. I have a gourmet chef in my medical practice who works
nice.
There.
We want him here.
It's a
Her
woman.
Here.
But, oh, she'll come back. She makes the most knock your socks off, incredibly great tasting food. It just happens to be super healthy.
Well, we appreciate your passion. We appreciate what you're doing. Eat more fruits and vegetables. Get those phytonutrients in. And thanks so much for coming in. This book is a gold mine of health information. It's got some tasty recipes to make this practical, like maybe orange cashew dressing and pecan maple salad. Once again, it's called Disease Proof Your Child by Dr. Joel Fuhrman. Look for it in bookstores or go to livingthelife.com. That was fun. Thank you. Some great ideas. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks. Louise, back to you.
Well, blows me down, all right? Remember, kids, you're gonna eat your spinach. Well, up next, Dame Penelope says it's not enough to eat right. You have to do it with style. We'll hear more from Ms. Manners' evil twin. Stay with us.